The sword and the shield.
Sustainability.
Radical and disruptive innovation.
Excellent.
I want to do something about it.
The long-range attitude in every one of the great companies said they had to think ahead, but they had to act now. So they're living in tomorrow by acting today. And they're doing things dramatically different. When I said strategic innovation, I meant radical and disruptive innovation, not incremental type of change. Not the kind of change where they go, let's try this and then, how did it turn out? No, let's turn the whole company upside down and get ready for what's going to happen. And they're doing it in a way that is obviously economic. There's no question about it. They have to make money, they have to make products, they have to make profits out of what they do. And they have to be involved in some sort of social interaction, but not like creating a foundation and saying, go take care of it. Looking at every stakeholder, every impact they have from the company's employees all the way through their customers and all the way through their supply chain, and how do I enrich the relationship with those people and have them believe in the same things we do so we don't harm the environment, so we don't harm people. And they also have to take care of the environment. They have no choice. They got to act on it. You know, you don't have to read it. You don't have to have good quality. You don't have to have good business execution. In fact, you don't have to have anything, and then you can go out of business. And you will go out of business. So we looked at these companies and we started diving in, and the first thing we did, we said, just how alert are these people to what's going on in the world? What do they think is the most critical risk that they see in the future? Now, this is a test. You'll get free admission tonight. If you can tell me what the first risk that, say, 10 of those companies saw. It was a common risk. Take a wild guess. Yes.
Data,
there's one. Not the first one, but data communications was critical. What's another?
Energy.
Energy is another one, up in the top five. Another one.
Skill shortage.
Yeah. Consumer trust.
Very sharp, very sharp. Go ahead.
Security.
Security.
Synergy.
Water.
Water. The first one was water scarcity in 10 different companies. There's about 60 to 70% of the world is living under water scarcity. One of the strangest countries in the world where that problem exists is the United States, and especially in California. And in California, if they don't do something to reverse the water shortage that they have now, within 20 years, they will be out of water. California. I knew there was a reason I wanted to live on the East Coast. A remarkable thing. You know, there's got to be a way that either we do something or business does something in spite of what the government's doing all over the world. There has to be, and there has to be people doing it, and there has to be companies that are doing it now. And the slower we take, you can guarantee there'll be more businesses out of business. And the ones that will survive are the ones that are taking the initiative now to do something about it. Thanks very much. Thank you.